Farm and Bushcraft, and today we're going to start with 2015 installments of Shadows in the Forest. What you saw was a brief teaser on Martin Station, the raid of Martin Station. It's a fort that was, which is now located in Ewing, Virginia, and it was very prevalent during the 1770s to the 1790s. Joseph Martin was in charge of the fort, and what I'll do is I'll put a brief history of the fort in the description of this video.
Martin Station was my first juried event, and what that means to a reenactor is you have to have all your I's dotted and your T's crossed. They want to see what you're going to look like, they want to see what you're going to portray. It was pretty rewarding for me to be judged and got the thumbs up. So apparently my research and my kit meets standards of a juried event. So I was quite happy with that. The head ranger there, Billy Heck, and his staff put a great deal of effort and time into the raid at Martin Station, along with all the other reenactors that come in and they volunteer to help produce the raid. So what are some of the things you're gonna see when you're at Martin Station? Well, there's quite a bit of sutlers there that comprise the market fair that they also bring there. People like Tony Baker, and as you can see right here, he's talking to Steve Davis. I actually picked up a sash from Tony, and I was quite happy with it and quite pleased with it. And we had a lot of discussion in reference to blankets and the weaving and the looms that were carried to the forts. They would bring the heddles along, according to Tony, and then when they finally got to their destination, that being the fort, the man would then make a frame for the loom so that they can continue with doing their weaving. Other things that you're going to see at the fort, it's not just relegated to the selling of wares there and not just having the recreated fort. They provide seminars for many different interests at that given time. So you'll have people there like Mad Ann Bailey. She told a story of the defiant women of the frontier. I actually did not get to see that seminar, but she was there and she usually puts on a really great show. People like Mark Baker, as you're going to see here, he told tales of the frontier and the brutality and the harshness of living on the frontier. One of my favorite seminars was a man by the name of Paul Jones, who actually gave a very, very good and in-depth discussion on historic fishing, historic angling. They talked about different things, such as coarse fishing versus angling or fly fishing. He showed different ways of making and creating a fishing line and discussed the type of hooks. And you'll see that in another video, which I'm going to do a complete video on the historic angling aspect of fishing in the 18th century, as presented by Paul. Wallace Gussler was there too, and he gave his 50 years of experience in research and documentation. If you're not familiar with Wallace, he was the curator at Colonial Williamsburg. He was also the master gunsmith there as well. Something else that you'll see is you'll see tradesmen that are there and craftsmen. They're actually displaying their talents while there. You may run into the gunsmith that's there. You may even run into Mike Miller. And Mike Miller, you'll see right here, he's talking to Steve, and I actually got to do an interview with him in the fall event, in which we'll have a little bit of fun with that interview as well, but that'll be for another video. And of course, when you get together with Steve, there's always going to be a little bit of jocularity, and we're always going to have a little bit of fun, and there sure as heck is going to be bacon frying in a frying pan. So let's take a look at a little bit of this, a little bit of some jocularity, and we'll just move right along.
Keep working, Brian. You go ahead and sit there in the shade.
Okay.
Thank you.
So, Matt, you want to talk about anything right now? You want to talk about the duality of man, or?
yes, how we're all doomed. We're all doomed to repeat ourselves.
Yeah, because nobody wants to learn from any mistakes.
Yeah, nobody wants to learn from our mistakes. Let's keep right at it.
You mind putting that on video, Steve?
What?
Exactly what you just said. People are asking me to have you put more video up, so please give us your dissertation on coloring of leggings.
Leggings, you know, started out as a brain tan color, and they... Oh, crud. Let me get that on video.
We got a disaster. We got a disaster.
That is, not too bad. That's a definite camp foul there. Oh, what I was saying, the way these leggings got this color is just because I wiped everything on them. I call it waterproofing. Most people would call it lazy.
Now, speaking of laziness, if we pan the camera this way, we see the little fella over there all wrapped up in his bundles. That's Alec. He's sleeping. He's tired.
What I want to do prior to showing you the footage of the raid is I wanted to read you a letter from Joseph Martin that he wrote to a friend prior to the attack. This letter is dated on Friday, the 27th of April, 1776. Old friend, I am writing this letter in haste, for at this very instant a large party of Shawnee have been spied crossing the Cumberland River. Mr. Red assured me that they are intent upon war, for they are painted, which is their custom. To worsen matters, I have been informed that Dragging Canoe spoke against the treaty made by Mr. Henderson, and has returned to the upper Cherokee towns and is gathering his young warriors. It is my suspicion that both parties may be twined together and fall upon us within a fortnight. I have called in every scout with the exception of three, which I have dispatched to the north, the west, and the south of this valley. I now have 36 men at this place, all with rifles and lead. However, powder is short, and I do not know how long it will hold. Captain Boone is in Kentucky with a party of 30 good men, and I pray he will return here in short manner, for he will be greatly needed if a battle ensues. The fort is now strong and will hold any attack that may come. Our provisions are well, as we have plenty of buffalo meat, and the men have begun to move the cattle and the horses near the fort. The women and children are making bullets, and they are collecting bandages, which I pray will not be necessary. I have sent dispatch to Colonel Preston, and I have asked him to send men from Holston to ride to our side, and pray that upon his request you grant him permission to do so. We must hold the valley at once, for to turn now would cause panic throughout the Clinch and Holston settlements, and I fear we would lose all we have suffered for. I am, sir, your most humble servant, Joseph Martin.
It's well worth the time, well worth the effort to go and see the raid at Martin Station, and I think there's a little bit of everything there for whatever could pique your interest. So we're going to go jump into the raid itself. I'm not going to show the whole entire raid, but I'll show you the best parts that I could, film while I was there. So sit back, enjoy the music, and enjoy the raid, and we'll go from there.
Must be a report coming in.
far.
Thank you.